Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
Welcome to our service this morning on this Tuesday in the final week of Advent. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Now our prayer and preaching. Almighty God,
to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden.
Therefore, in the light of Christ, let us confess our sins. Heavenly Father, you exalted the humble and meek. Give us humble and contrite hearts. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you grew towards the birth in the Virgin's womb. You planted also in our hearts and lives. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Holy Spirit, you overshadowed Mary that she might become God-bearer. Fill us with your heavenly gifts. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Almighty God, who in Jesus Christ has given us a kingdom that cannot be destroyed, forgive us our sins, open our eyes to God's truth, strengthen us to do God's will, and give us the joy of his kingdom. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We now have our collect question. Eternal God, as Mary waited for the birth of your Son, as we wait for his coming in glory, bring us to the birth pangs of this present age, to see with her of good salvation. In Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Please be seated for our meeting. Prepare the way of the Lord. Make his path straight. and all flesh shall see the salvation of God. Alleluia. Mary said, my soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior. For he has looked with favour on the lowliness of his servant. Surely, from now on, all generations will call me blessed. For the Mighty One has done great things for me, and holy is his name. His mercy is for those who fear him, from generation to generation. He has shown strength with his arm. He has scattered the proud in the thoughts of their hearts. He has brought down the powerful from their thrones and lifted up the lowly. He has filled the hungry with good things and sent the rich away empty. He has helped his servant Israel in remembrance of his mercy, according to the promise he made to our ancestors, to Abraham and to his descendants forever. Mary remained with Elizabeth for about 3 months and then returned to the Lord. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ. Eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate from the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and was made man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
In the power of the Spirit, and in union with Christ, let us pray to the Father. Loving God, we pray for your grace. We pray for your grace as situations change and unravel. We pray for your grace where there is disappointment or confusion. We pray for your presence alongside all who are affected by the coronavirus, directly or indirectly. And we pray for your comfort for all who require it this morning. Be with all who are struggling, all who are downhearted. Bring us your grace and restore hope where it is lost. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Lord, we pray for grace for all who are making decisions at this time. We pray for all who have power and influence, from the largest corporations and governments to our local government and our local leaders. We pray for decisions that are just and fair and put the lives of people before other considerations. And we pray for all who lead your church, Lord, around the world and here in the UK, praying today for Her Majesty the Queen, for our Archbishops Justin and Stephen, hearing down for our bishops, Paul, Sarah, their leadership team, and assistant bishops. And we pray and give thanks, Lord, for all who lead here in this parish, lay and ordained. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray that all connected to our schools will know your grace this Christmas holiday, as we pray for a time of rest and recovery for teachers, support staff, head teachers, and for parents and children, for students, that there will be a time to rest and a break before returning to education in the new year. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
And we pray for all who have worked so hard this year to keep our hospitals moving, food on our shelves, to keep our public transport and emergency services going. We are so grateful, Lord, to each and every one. And today we pray for all who are unwell in mind, body or spirit, especially in this church, in this parish. We pray this morning for Jessica McCaskill, for Betty Connor, Doreen Murray, Derek Middleton, Pat Middleton, Dorothy Macbeth, Stella Matthews, Tom McKenzie, Melissa Shepherd, Wynn Alderslade, and we have a request for prayers for sisters Judith and Jen. And in a moment of silence, Lord, we lift to you those people on our hearts today that need to know your healing presence in their lives. May they each know your comfort and your peace, Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
And loving and merciful God, we pray for those most seriously ill today, for anyone in hospital and ICU, for anyone receiving palliative care, and for anyone for whom today may be their last. We ask you to comfort all who are weeping, and to welcome their loved ones into their heavenly home, into your arms, where you hold all of those we know for the long sin. And we remember especially at this time of year, Maureen Patterson, Dorothy Mill, Marjorie School, Andrew Love. May light perpetual shine upon them. May they rest in peace and rise in glory. Amen.
May the God of peace make you completely holy, ready for the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. And the peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Let us offer one another a distant sign of the peace. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this bread to set before you, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this wine to set before you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become for us the cup of salvation.
Blessed be God forever.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
Father, we give you thanks and praise through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your living Word, through whom you have created all things, who was sent by you in your great goodness to be our Saviour. By the power of the Holy Spirit he took flesh. As your Son, born of the Blessed Virgin, he lived on earth and went about among us. He opened wide his arms for us on the cross. He put an end to death by dying for us, and revealed the resurrection by rising to new life. So he fulfilled your will and won for you a holy people. And now we give you thanks, because you sent him to redeem us from sin and death, and to make us inheritors of everlasting life, that when he shall come again in power and great triumph to judge the world, we may with joy behold the appearing, and in confidence may stand before him. Therefore, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we proclaim your great and glorious name, forever praising you and saying,
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Lord, you are holy indeed, the source of all holiness. Grant that by the power of your Holy Spirit and according to your holy will, these gifts of bread and wine may be to us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, who in the same night that he was betrayed took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. In the same way, after supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me. Christ is the bread of life. When we eat this bread and drink this cup,
we proclaim your death, Lord Jesus, until you come in glory.
And so, Father, calling to mind his death on the cross, his perfect sacrifice made once for the sins of the whole world, rejoicing in his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, and looking for his coming in glory, we celebrate this memorial of our redemption. As we offer you this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, we bring before you this bread and this cup, and we thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and serve you. Send the Holy Spirit on your people, and gather into one in your kingdom all who share this one bread and one cup, so that we, in the company of the Blessed Virgin Mary, St. Peter, and all the saints, may praise and glorify you forever, through Jesus Christ our Lord. By whom, and with whom, and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory be yours, Almighty Father, for ever and ever.
Amen.
Let us pray with confidence as our Saviour has taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen.
Every time we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim the Lord's death
until he comes.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, grant us peace.
Jesus is the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those who are called to his supper.
Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word, and I shall be healed.
Let us pray. We give you thanks, O Lord, for these heavenly gifts. Kindle in us the fire of your Spirit, that when your Christ comes again, we may shine as light before his face, who is alive and reigns now and forever.
Amen.
Father of all,
we give you thanks and praise that when we were still far off, you met us in your Son and brought us home. Dying and living, he declared your love, gave us grace, and opened the gate of glory. May we who share Christ's body live his risen life. We who drink his cup bring life to others. We whom the Spirit lights give light to the world. Keep us firm in the hope you have set before us, so we and all your children shall be free, and the whole earth live to praise your name, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Christ, the Son of Righteousness, shine upon you, scatter the darkness from before your path, and make you ready to meet him when he comes in glory. And the blessing of Almighty the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you always.
Amen.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
In the name of Christ. Amen.